How do you cut your sandwiches?
I go straight down the middle, not like that dude did across. Right?
You go vertical.
Vertically cut.
Explain
down the
your reasoning, ma'am.
I don't know. I feel like anytime I go diagonal, I have like the idea that it's going to look all nice and cute and fancy, but I always end up breaking the corners off. And then it's all weird. I like cutting just straight down the middle. Get to the point, nice and easy. Take a bite right into that. No
get to
deal.
The point.
Get to the point. Just cut it right down the middle.
Excuse me. Do you know how triangles and shapes work? If you want the point, you got to go diagonal. Here's the reason of why diagonal. First of all, name me a restaurant where you go and you get a sandwich at a restaurant and they cut down the middle. Gross.
I'm not making a sandwich at my house for a restaurant. I'm making it at home. It's a homemade sandwich.
No.
If I
you
go
gotta
to a restaurant,
go diagonal.
That's one thing.
Here's the reason you go diagonal. First of all, it's way prettier. It's way more beautiful. Like if you not only you cut
it's
it diagonal,
way more beautiful.
But then you like crisscross stack them, and it just looks sexy. Second of all, first of all, it's great for eating because you can either go triangle first. Right? And you can go like smaller and gets bigger and bigger.
Okay.
Or you go down the line.
So you're saying you bite the point first.
Sometimes I bite the point first. I absolutely do. I'm not going to lie to you. I sometimes go point first.
And the third of all. But I don't want a bite full of crust right from the get-go.
No, my problem is you kind of save the crust for the very end, right? With the triangle. You get it down to the point and then you take down that point. The next thing about the diagonal cut of a sandwich is you get a great look at the entire inside of the sandwich, right? And I just think it's clean edges. Give me the diagonal way to cut a sandwich.
I can't say I have any like super fancy reasoning why I cut down the middle, but I feel like that you're just trying too hard. Just eat the dang sandwich.
No.
Or don't cut it at all.
First of all,
just
I think when you cut down the middle, I think sometimes it's hard to gauge exactly the middle and then they get uneven and oh my
gosh. Wait, you're telling me it's easier to get even cutting diagonal. That is
because
a
you just
load
put the,
of garbage.
But you put the edge of the knife at the corner of the bread, Lauren.
Yeah, but then you put the edge of the knife in the middle of the bread.
How do you know where the middle is? The little indentation?
No, you just look.
The two humps?
It's not hard for someone to look and find the middle of the sandwich.
Again,
I don't know what the argument is.
When you see a commercial for grilled cheese, like a Kraft singles, Kraft singles, they never cut it down the middle, those sick freaks. They cut it diagonally.
Yes, but at home, I do what I want. I'm not worried about
what
the restaurants do.
You should Google the inventor of the sandwich. I don't know if the guy's name was Sand and then his last name was Witch.
Wow, there you go.
But the inventor of the sandwich, if you look up on Wikipedia, I bet you the first example of a sandwich, whenever sandwiches were invented, they cut that ish diagonal.
Now, let me ask you this. Do you only cut diagonally when it's like two pieces of bread, like a grilled cheese or a PB&J sandwich?
No, club sandwich,
right. Okay,
turkey,
so
roast
club
beef.
On like a baguette? On a hoagie, you're gonna cut that diagonally? No, you're gonna cut it down the middle.
I don't appreciate that. I don't think you should bring in. This is not about hoagies. This is about classic sandwich bread.
No, if you go get a sub sandwich at any sub place, okay, they're going to cut it in the middle. Nobody's cutting
it
diagonally.
You act like I normally just ask for one big hunk of bread. Like I'm not getting some small little. Ooh, can I get the 3-incher, please?